Let's face it, owning a home today sucks. 12 different accounts to pay your bills, trying to keep up with documents, filing insurance claims, it's all a big hassle. Grease fires, plumbing leaks, toilet overflows, this and that and that and this. We can all use a little bit of help. So what's your home plan? Sign up for Home Plan today and get a little bit of help managing your home. It's home management made simple. Sign up at joinhomeplan.com.
Record, you flip that motherfucker, you put the volume on, and you say, welcome back, connoisseurs, to the Cognac Corner, recorded in historic Soulard, Missouri. Round of applause. I am.
Come on, it's the podcast daddy.
And I am.
All right, podcast daddy.
You know, sometimes.
Podcast Poppy.
But you know, I'm always going to.
Come on. It's the podcast.
I fucked that up, guys.
Eddie.
My bad, y'all. Postman, this one.
Podcast Eddie, come back.
I am back. Podcast Eddie. Mr. Damn it. Mr. Talk to Me Nice, Mr. Doing Too Much. Podcast Poppy, podcast visionary. I am Marcus Onesimus Boston. And today, we have new. Put your name up because we got some high ass. We got high technology over here. Nope, that's my name. Oh, wrong name. Got it. We have Jezeray down in Cognac Corner. Thank you so much for coming down to the corner and accepting all the complications we had in this motherfucking corner.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Your patience is, damn it, wrong way. Your patience is never. Never disinvalue. I'll just take that name away. Maybe I should get an assistant. Got it. All right, here we are. Here we are. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for coming down to the corner. If you're drinking 1738, some delicious cognac down in a Cognac Corner. So how you been? How you been?
You know, I think that's a loaded question, but overall, I'm very well. I have no major complaints.
That's good, because that, you know, complaining really doesn't help nobody, you know? It really it's just sometimes just easiest to just you know, make the most of it. You know, be the best you can what you got.
Hell yeah. Like the Mariah Carey clip. It doesn't say active anymore.
Damn, what does it say?
Nothing. There we go.
Oh, well, yeah, because it's not on you, so it switched over so you know when the camera's on you, yeah. So now it's a wide shot, my bad. I didn't. No one ever said that before. No one ever paid attention that much to the cameras, even though that it did that. I had no idea.
My bad.
No, we learned together. We're here as a family. We're here as a family, but I will do like this, and that way we both active. Come on now, boy. Bow. Yeah. So now I got some of us, one of you. Being great. So one of the topics I had on my heart was what is apologize for that. The one question I have, what is the value of transition dick and pussy? Now I asked that question on a previous show and I didn't like my answer I got from my audience and from my host that day. It got very into the mush. I was like, there's a value to someone that comes in your life as a stepping stone. You know, they're not going to be here for the season, reason, lifetime comes up pretty quick with saying that. And there's a value of that, but there's also a downside that you can come too used to being a transition that you don't learn how to turn yourself into a destination. Because your behavior has come accustomed to always letting them go. Well, maybe you should make them stay. So what do you think? So I think it's a high value to it, and it's a place for it. It's a place for everything.
I totally think there's a place for it because sometimes you just need that stopgap, right? People have needs. That's a part of your lifestyle, and there are other people who fulfill those needs really well.
Right.
Right? And it's also an understanding that you're here for a good time, not a long time. And for an amount of time that really will work for you.
Yep.
Right? Until you get to the point where it doesn't.
Yeah.
And you know exactly when that happens. You know exactly what that feels like. And then you have to make the decision. How do I want to approach this? How do I want to get better? and better in the sense of not for other people first, but you have to be better for you and realize that you want better. And then what does better look like?
Yes.
Right.
Yes. Right? You got to have a plan where you're going. I think that for me, I never had a destination. I was just sailing the seven seas. And then for a while, you know, there's a bunch of y'all on this boat. I think y'all can beat pirates forever. And slowly but surely, you dock once too many times and they don't come back on the boat. And they found something hot and it made them stay. And you still like, all right, crew. Wait a minute. I thought we was committed to this life. Until you not. It's all good until it ain't.
Until it ain't. Until it ain't, right?
We get into it off the heezy for sheezy. Mm. Oh. Yeah.
But you see, that is also a sign of growth, though. That a person even gets to that train or that line of thinking.
I will agree.
Because you probably were not thinking like this 5 to 7 years ago.
Nah. Damn, what was I thinking about five? I can't even think about what I was thinking about that long ago.
See? But you're growing. So you can't be like, this is where I am. Because mm-hmm. the only things that don't grow continuously are things that are dead. Right? So every day that you are... Thank you. Every day that you are living... You are growing. Now, whether you are growing up, growing
out. Amen to that shit.
There it is.
Growing up, growing out, growing in, growing down. You are still growing. You just have to pay attention to what direction.
The direction. Because what was another quote I love to say? Change is inevitable, but growth is... Wait, that's not it. I think it's change is... inevitable, but growth is optional. Maybe that's it. I might have made it overcomplicated. But it's mostly saying growth is a choice. You're going to get old. You're going to change. But you have to choose to grow.
Yeah.
You will change. And it's amazing how people have a hard time changing or believe that you change. They want you to stay where they used to you being at, too.
Because it's very comfortable. It's very comfortable. Complacency is comfortable. But it also will drive you crazy.
If you want, like, you know, you can move that mic around. Oh. It's very, you know, very giving. Like, you know, I like your mind right up in, you know.
I just assume it picks up all the sounds.
Yeah, they look good. They look better than they actually work.
Okay, I'm going to sit right here.
Yeah. You probably okay. I'm probably just being overly, you know, overly what I do. Probably overly
This is cautious. Your thing. I'm here to follow instructions, man.
No, I'm going to throw up a picture. So what's the next question? So what makes a woman a savage?
I think when she decides to behave just as she wants without regard for societal norms.
Yeah, I like women that are confident in themselves. Like, I don't need you to be nobody than who you are because I can't make you no better than you want to be.
That's true, because we're not out here molding bitches.
Yeah, I need you to hit the ground running. I want you to know who you are, what you're not going to deal with, what you are going to deal with, and I have a choice to either agree or not agree.
Yeah.
It's okay. People have a heart. I mean, rejection does suck, and rejection isn't only a romantic thing. It's also even with friendships. Some friendships, they would come for you with being... They number two. Now you're number one on everybody else scorecard besides theirs. And they realize, oh, I don't like number two. Yeah, because you still back where number one was okay. The world has changed and I've changed with it. And everybody ain't got to go.
They don't. But that's a hard realization for a lot of people to realize that they are not the star of everyone else's story. Right?
I like a good supporting actor role for myself.
You know, teamwork makes a dream work. That's what they always taught us, right? And in a lot of respects, that's true. And you have to realize, I think a lot of us overinflate our places in people's lives because they can go on without you.
Yeah.
And you can go on without them.
Yes.
Yeah.
People die every day, B. And you talking about a motherfucker that's alive?
Let them live their life, man.
Yeah.
However they choose to live.
Season, reason, lifetime. Like, you can't take a Ferrari to Schnucks to get groceries. Ain't going to fit. You got to know what's for what.
Yeah.
Like, you get you a Range Rover. Good for everywhere it go. if you really want to be, if you're trying to be cautious and smart with your time, you get with that word. Hey,
God damn it. That's also another level of growth to even realize.
Oh, look at me growing up.
To even realize that, right? And not everybody is there yet. My prayer is that they arrive at that destination, mm-hmm. but I can't wait for them.
Yeah,
and neither can you.
Yeah, the train keeps going with or without you, and sometimes people think they're ready for a train for a car that train they not. Like I do a lot of shit and I move a lot. I move around, but some people can fall. Like you know, I had a recent situation where like. Fam, you don't even know me. Like, you feel the type of way about me, but you don't even know my real name yet. You know, I'm like, you got to pace yourself. Even if you feel that way, you still got to pace yourself. You got to have a game face. You can't just show me your hand. Like, nah, what would you do with that? I'm not that responsible to not take, I don't want to take advantage of that because I know you going to let me do what I want to do. Come
but
on
you
now.
You are that responsible because you didn't do whichever you wanted to do.
Damn.
Right? You're your own moral code. Mm. And people don't know your moral code until they actually get in community with you. Because just by looking at you, they're gonna be like, oh, he might run amok in my life.
But I would not. I would never take advantage of right. your peace.
But you never know.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good point. That's a very good point. Next question. How do you know you're good in bed? Now, before you answer this question, I'm going to have me a drink.
That's a very interesting question.
He's the author called Cognac Thoughts. This is a segment. I skipped the first segment. Damn, let me get back to it. So.
I've never given out any formal surveys.
Mm-hmm.
But I also have never received any audible complaints.
Mm. That's a very HR way of answering that question. It was clean. It was a clean answer to a dirty question.
I try.
I'm impressed. Very much impressed. Yeah, I don't know.
I would also think that a telltale sign would be like repeat.
A lot of women answer that question is they've been stalked or they've been, you know, he won't leave it. He can't move on. That's been a common answer.
Well, it's two people having sex. So,
yeah. Like so I never
can't move on.
Yeah. I never met a vagina I couldn't leave. And then she go to tell me that I'm still a virgin. Cause you haven't had nothing that can grip you. And she got really, really, really graphic with what she was delivering.
That's unnecessary. I mean, for me, that's, I can't.
Yeah. I was like, how I would approach it. So all my body's on me, nothing, huh? I'm just back to zilch.
I mean, it is 2022. You can zero it out if you like.
People had COVID babies.
They did.
Baffling. It's baffling to me. Just the hate. I'm just hating, guys. I'm sorry. Just the hating on those that made it. What is a sneaky link?
Something that we are far too old to discuss. And but we can. It's from my understanding, because I love a good TikTok and the youths talk about it on the TikTok.
Uh-huh.
Sneaky link is somebody that you are having relations with that you should not be.
Mm.
But I also feel like some people may not understand the definition.
Go ahead.
Because
girl.
If we're both single, what's the sneaky?
What's the sneaky part for you? Right.
We're both single.
Yeah, but some people I've invited over in times in my life that I don't even know about.
Oh, that you would be embarrassed if people.
It's not embarrassing. I just niggas.
I mean, I feel like discretion is key.
I like privacy.
But I
ain't finna act like I don't know you, but like we ain't gonna be doing nothing extra. Oh, maybe. I don't know. Yes.
What's extra, though?
I don't know. I got out here lying.
I'm going to say, let me say this up front. I'm very big on communication. So if this is just supposed to be like we meet under the cover of darkness, please say that. And if you want it to be more, let's say that as well. Let's just be very plain about what we want.
I just want to call me when the kids go to sleep.
Okay.
And let me know when, you know, you got some free time.
I feel like if you make that known off bat, then you give that woman a choice whether she wants to deal with it or not.
Mm-hmm.
But don't lead like trying to wine and dine her when all you're trying to do is get the draws.
Come
right?
on the road with me.
Right.
Come on over to my place.
There's no need for it. I mean,
that actually ruined things for me, where I do too much, like just treating them like a woman, like, you know, let's go out and do shit.
Treat
and
them like a person, but have the conversation about how things are, how it's supposed to be. Like, if y'all are going to be like activity buddies,
mm-hmm.
then that includes, hey, let's, you know, let's go play some pinball, have some dinner. I mean, that's
I like to play darts. That's my shit.
Right. Okay. So y'all go play darts. Teach her how to play darts. Y'all have a couple drinks.
I do like drinks.
Right.
Love is a game for fools.
But this, there and still, you have to have that communication, because if this becomes a weekly thing or a multi-time thing during the week, are you now dating? Have things changed? Right? Just always keep the conversation
open. Who brought this raggedy ass ice?
I think that was a contribution by you.
I'm catering. I'm housekeeping. I am landscaper, shoveler, salt man. Shit. Okay, well, we hit with the questions now. I must keep on moving down the list. What makes a good man a good man?
One who doesn't call himself a good man.
That's it. All right, moving on. That was that one. All right. She just...
was very excessive. Damn, damn,
damn. All right, everybody. Let's get back to this show. You just shit on that question.
I didn't. We can discuss it.
Yeah, I don't know either. Like, I know some guys I would consider good men, because I think their character is almost equal to mine, but that's not, I can know women that would say different.
Because it's different than being, the relationships are different. Like, that's your friend.
Yeah, that's my guy.
And then that's their romantic partner.
Yeah, he should right? know them.
And so things can get real fuzzy once we cross that romance line. Once I'm asking you to be emotionally mature and physically present.
Yeah.
You know, once I'm asking you to do these things, be a partner in this life with me. Then your goodness can come into question.
Mm. You said that, girl. Damn. It's been a long time since I said something like us. We.
Do you miss it?
I do. Because I see it so much. And I seen it in the most healthy and positive way. I was like, damn. What's keeping me? What am I doing wrong? I just start writing the list and say, ah, that makes sense. Mr. Makes Sense.
I mean, you could also write a list, but...
I ain't really good at it.
But you could also realize that's hindsight bias. You're going to be harder on yourself today than you should be. And I had to learn that myself.
Yeah. I've always had issues with feeling like I was deserving of things that I wanted. Even when I was a kid, like, I was like, okay, cool. If I couldn't have something that I asked for, I would make the best of what I got. Mm-hmm. And so I would make the best of every situation. Like, cool, I could have been this. But I'm like, all right, well, yeah, you could be also get hit by a bus. So you know what? I'm going to be blessed and grateful, shut the fuck up and sit my ass down. You know, I never felt like I was missing out on something, or if I don't go to this thing, I'm going to be left out. Like, nah, because I need my own motherfucking company. I never allowed things that oftentimes put you in a situation of making a bad decision, because I was like, that shit don't make no sense. So we going over here to do what with who? For how long? Then what? Nah, I'm going to bed. You know, somebody else would be like, ah, you know what? Fuck, let's go. I'm like, no, how about a fuck it in my jeans? How about, like, you know what? I am tired and I ain't finna deal with this shit. I'm like, nah.
That critical thinking.
Too damn much. Too much. Sometimes you need to just do some fuck shit and just, no, I shouldn't be here.
I think there's plenty of time for that. I think there's plenty of time for making questionable decisions and then hoping that the questionable decision still lands you on this realm.
You get no rope to make questionable decisions after a certain age. So if you miss, I missed out on my questionable. We still fuck up at this age.
People do it every day.
People
do it every day.
Motherfuckers don't be telling me shit. I thought I was out of time.
I mean, I feel like you are out of time because you made that declaration.
once you make it known, you know you fucking up. You don't get no, nigga. You know what you did. I don't get no benefit of doubt.
I mean, that's the same thing. My mother taught me long ago, do not be in a position where a person has to tell you sorry more than once because mm-hmm. now they are a sorry individual.
Mama had bars.
And who wants to associate with sorry individuals? Correct?
I heard a good line from Ace and Amber on Young Mary and Lit. Go ahead. Bow. They said, if your relationships ain't taking you nowhere, then why you in them?
Very true.
Ships are supposed to take you places. That's what romantic relationship. The reason ship is in the word. If you in a relationship, friendship or romantic, is it taking you somewhere? Is it making you better? If you ain't, then why you on this goddamn boat going nowhere? I said, man, nigga, I said it. Got bars. I said, that's man, hey, young man, right there. He's going places.
Yeah. Man's going places. Absolutely correct, though.
Yeah.
And then we can get into that same space of like, you might be traveling, but which direction are you going in?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Do you really want to be bonded out of prison every weekend over this relationship? Like, is that worth it? Or do you want to be sad and not feeling like yourself? Just to say that you have a partner. And this is not even a... I mean, now they're a partner, but they're a partner in your demise.
My thing was, I always believe fire was hot and that water's wet. Some people got to drown and believe that motherfucker's deadly. Like, no, I believe it. I don't need... Once you say some shit as what it is, I take your word for it. I don't have to test. If you say you a bad motherfucker, cool, works for me. I don't need you to waste your bad motherfucker on me.
Yeah, I feel like I've learned a lot just from observing other people.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Got a quote for you. A smart man learns from his own mistakes, but a wise man learns from mistakes of others.
I agree.
And I was like, that shit looks stupid. I'm cool. And I all y'all parents now. Told y'all. Shouldn't have just went home like I did. Staying out. Only get you in trouble. Shytown.
People are right where they're supposed to be.
Yes. Well, I'm here to say that you pregnant again, no man. Maybe you should be somewhere else. Maybe it's enough.
I'm not going to comment on that. I'm just going to continue to say that people are right where they need to be.
Well, I'm saying you should have done better. When you know better, you do better. That's I'm kidding. Hope. I'm just hating. I love being a good single mother. When was your last vacation?
Oh, probably 2019.
Where you go?
I think Chicago that year.
Oh, I haven't Chicago in a while. My last vacation wasn't, I had a great time, but she didn't. Mm. And I think about all the women I let go, and it was for the right reasons, but I was like, damn, maybe I should just held on.
Mm-mm.
I just it had my that sounds petty. I almost said monetary reasons, not necessarily monetary reasons, but
you were getting needs fulfilled.
Yes, yeah, I was able to run over there and get some peace when I wanted a break from this crazy life I live on this side. But After a while, we couldn't talk like I like to talk. And she was like, you're doing the most. You don't listen well. I like you to listen. Not just to me, just to the world. If you're talking, you're not listening all the time. Sometimes you just sit. It's okay to sit in the car and be quiet.
I heard this is a quote by a black man, band teacher, uh-huh. band director. He told us, a group of us, he said, you put your top lip on your bottom lip. And that's called shutting the fuck up.
Yes.
Right? And I've carried that with me. Because it makes so much sense. It's so simple.
Man, it goes so far. And as long as motherfuckers, they don't know shit to talk the most. I say, Why you talking so much, sir? And you ain't said shit.
And those are also the people who are not comfortable with quiet.
Amen to that shit.
Yeah, you right. You right. Now fuck that bitch. Fuck that bitch. Fuck that bitch. Fuck that bitch. But Cancun was fun. It's good times. I need to travel more. But like, I don't know, if you don't have a traveling parent, do you become a traveling like child? If you didn't travel much, like as a child, do you become an adult that maybe don't feel the need to travel much? But then maybe if you get with somebody that does travel, like then you would get into the habit of. But I don't think like all my friends that travel were also kids that traveled. Like they parents would take them shit. But like I know some kids that never travel. I know some people that those never traveled that travel all the time. So I guess that was, I don't know, drunk thought. Think about traveling. You like to travel?
I love to travel. Love to travel. We took some trips as a kid, like some trips we just knew we were gonna take. Mm. But it was also a lot of us, so we weren't, you know, they wouldn't put us on a plane going to Disneyland, you know. But I do feel like road trips as a child develop me in certain ways.
Mm-hmm. It stretches your experience. You realize the world is bigger than your front porch. You gotta get outside and touch some people, see things, have conversations you maybe ain't ready for.
Listen to talk radio. That's why I developed a knack for listening to like NPR and stuff mm-hmm. like that.
Mm-hmm. I remember I used to travel down with my grandfather, Jackson, Mississippi. I said, "Grandpa, so that's where you from, huh?" This is it, huh? All right. I don't know none of you niggas here. I'm just here with this. I'm here with my grandpa. I can't get in the pool at the hotel.
I can't get in the pool. I traveled 11 hours.
That's the first Onesimus right there. Ooh, this is a good one. Why do men get friend zoned? Oh, I'm glad you asked that, sir. Let me tell you why.
I think it's the same reason why women get friend zoned. Well, no, let me not say that. I can't speak for men. When a man becomes friend zoned with me, it's just I go off my first instinct. My first instinct. So when I meet a man, if I don't have like, oh, he's attractive, I want to, mm-hmm. you know, explore something with him. Mm-hmm. I want to see if this could be something. Then I move him into that. Okay, we can connect on some other level. But then you don't even have that connection with some men. It's just like we are both in the same space at the same time.
Yeah. Damn. I hurt my feelings. No, I didn't. The question is true. I spent some years in my 20s that I don't wish I can get back, but that was a lesson. Like, a woman knows what you want from me when she sees you a very shortly with an interaction. Also, if you don't get it within the first 6 weeks, you ain't gonna get it. So if whatever's supposed to happen don't happen that first like discovery period and bullshit and that time, it's weeks, brother. Some of y'all might not have that much time. Because I was told I'm not threatening. And I took that as a, because even I like one with some spice, a little bit of murder. Like, I don't give off murder energy. Like, I'm not going to give you, oh, he going to come get it. I'm going to be like, hey, can we talk about why you want to give it to me? Mm-hmm. My savagery, my threateningness has decreased with my elevation and knowledge.
I don't think it has to, though.
No, I just have to be more, I just have to...
Maybe you don't feel like you want to be that with her.
I really don't. I just, I don't. I don't know. Like, there was a time when I was out here just. It was a time when I was very threatening. Like, you know, you hang out with me, you might get got. And you better tread lightly on the motherfucking jokes in a friendly way. You know, we're still doing friendly things, but you know, you see me out with somebody enough times. It's been enough times. Now it's like, nah, we just feel friends. So I get all kind of bodies placed on me because it might look like, because they know how I used to be And the behavior is the same, but the execution is not. I'd be going hungover sleep. I'm like, ah, I could, but oh, that bed. You know what changed for me? You know what the change came in? When I got my eye mask. A lot of things changed.
That's funny.
I had an episode with the operation room podcast. I had Lolo and Dr. Ebony on, and I got to a conversation about eye mask. She was like, you know, you should have, the problem is sleeping beauty. You should be damn, it was a good one too. She said something like, you got your eye mask on, you should be ready to go. You be sleepy, your neck slang instead of motherfucking sleeping beauty or something like that. I was like, I was really proud of my eye mask too. I'd be like, I'm
really elevated my sleeping experience. I sleep with eye mask sometimes.
I don't sleep without one. I got one in my whole bag. I got one everywhere I potentially might be. Got my eye mask.
Well, I mean, I feel like that's just smart, because if you're living that type of lifestyle, there are plenty of people who like to keep the TV on, who
I keep need a light I keep, yeah, on. I keep TV on, but I put on the timer because I like to listen to shit to go sleep. I
just put on rain sounds, but I like complete darkness.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But some people, you could just be sleeping over a friend's house and they like to keep a light on. And
yeah.
You can't sleep like that. So you could just, your eye mask on.
Yeah. When the eye mask goes on, the chances of me getting on this bed are slim.
Yeah, you don't even take that from me anymore. It could be 5. I typically get home about 5:30. Baby, that's a wrap. Unless I'm very dedicated to whatever that event is supposed to be.
You ain't lying. I got my phone dry, dog. My shit dry. I could build a motherfucking sandcastle.
Same.
I said, man, my phone used to be dripping. That used to be like, well, I got a sound effect I'm trying to stall to get to that. Let me see what this is. Oh, my bad.
Seed of my life. It's watermelon.
I don't know where the watermelon came in from. What was that, young man? I'm going to use my real name. That was so bad.
Strong water.
Hey, y'all, I'm sorry. I don't know why that sound effect was in my soundboard. That even, it had nothing to do with nothing to the price of gas. Speaking of price of gas, good God. What you gonna do?
I'm gonna put $35 in my tank, and however far that gets me, that's how far it gets me.
That's it.
Because I'm not getting back on public transit.
Nah.
Not doing that.
No, yeah, that's. I pray for those them big ass gas lows and ass trucks. I hope y'all can really afford that life.
I mean, you have to have a price where you say enough is enough. I already claimed mine. I mean, yours might look different.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the truth. Tell the truth, shame the devil. So, Jay, what's going on with you in your life? What's been going on? Since you're back in these streets, Big Purr.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, honestly, it's been a lot of, like, emotional growth and resting.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So. And then really deciding what I want out of this next relationship.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And what I realized is that since my standards have changed,
right,
it's going to be dry for a minute. Like, it's not going to be any viable options because what I'm looking for has changed. So it is definitely a reality that one might not be ready to face, but it's like, well, I don't want to repeat the same patterns. So I need to ask for different things.
Yeah, you got to pray with detail. I think I'm naturally a broad requester.
Very open.
Yeah, but like, I want to bless everybody. No, like, who do you really want to pray? Like, who are you really praying for? I don't know, these big encompassing prayers is cool, but we need precision strikes, okay?
What I've learned is specificity is key.
It is.
Right? So I, too, struggle with having a very open and welcoming personality. And that landed me in a lot of situations that I shouldn't have been in.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, like, nothing dangerous, but, like, you don't really need to talk to this person.
Yeah.
Right? You can let that go. But so what I've learned is specificity is key. You really have to be laser sharp with what you want and what you will accept. And it's not approaching it with no compromise. It's knowing that if things aren't the way that you have expressed you want them to be, it's never going to work for you.
Yeah.
You will be unhappy.
Yeah, I can't think I've ever been unhappy. I've never been in a relationship long enough to be unhappy, which is probably a problem. All the endings came to an end because proximity was an issue from the beginning. Because I know, like, I'm only going to be willing to drive so far for so long till this drive don't make no sense.
That's real.
And I'm like, you know, as great as you are, and you have the same issue as well, because, like, if you're not, you know, I've tried it in a dozen different versions, but I realized whoever this person may be either has to be understanding that I don't live a traditional hourly lifestyle, and that a lot of places I'm going to take you would be places where I'm known, and a lot of the friends and people you might meet will be women, and I had a handful of guys. So there's any level of, if you are heavy with trust issues and not being strong within your own 2 feet, this will work for you. Because I'm not here to be your constant, what's that shit called? Not affirmation.
Reassurance.
Yeah, it's a word for, I'm not here to always be confirming you all day when you need to be your own. I need you to be your own biggest cheerleader, so I can just give me a spot next to you and just, you know, sub in or be a part of your already fan club. You can't depend on me to make you always reassuring. Cause that's not what I'm here for. That's just not what I am. Like, I'm gonna make you know you're solid. I'm gonna give you confirmation, but I'm not. Some women need confirmation all the time. Why you ain't do this? Hey, are you happy without me? Like, I want to want you. I don't want you need me. Cause I'm gonna let you down.
I mean, and now we're getting into, like, the weeds of relationships, right? So, I just finished this book called Attached, and it talked about the attachment styles that people tend to have.
Mm-hmm.
And so hearing you say that, it makes me think of this anxious attachment style where one person comes across as very needy and mm-hmm. very unsure and insecure, and they always need that validation that you're not going to leave them, that you're mm-hmm. always going to be right there, yeah. right? And so that can be a problem for people who are very secure in themselves mm-hmm. and the way they move.
Yep.
Or for a person who is avoidant of their feelings and will give you just enough attention to make them think they want you.
Uh-huh.
And then they turn cold.
Yeah.
Which even further fuels that fire of an anxious attachment
type. Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, man, that's a great book. That's amazing. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
I mean, I know I was getting on my friend's nerves when I was reading that book, because I'm like, you need to read this because it makes you reevaluate, of course, your romantic interactions, but also your friendships
mm-hmm.
and your relationships in general.
I think most of my friendships are pretty overall solid. I think all of my bridges are well maintained. So if I, you know, invite somebody out or, like, you know, like this today, like, I knew we was cool enough. So I was like, let me see what she doing to see what's going on. I think I have enough people like that. And I usually even attract people like that over time. Like, I never thought we'd be friends, but here we are, you know, doing what we're doing. And I think it's just, you know, taking the time to value how valuable just a check-in every once in a while is to maintain a bridge or friendship, to where you can always pick up like that nigga's been kicking every day, but I ain't seen you in 6 months or whatever it might be. Cause it takes a level of knowing how you friendship, how you communicate, and that maybe everybody ain't here to be for a while. Maybe it's here to be a friend for 6 months and you swing back around and it's just what it is. Or, you know, you dip off into what you dip into. I leave all doors open, come back. You know, because it maybe not, might not work out. I'm still outside. He meet me right here. I'm always doing something. But even in relationship, I still would have balance between, like, I'm going to be with the girlfriend for the weekend, see you niggas on Monday or whatever, or she'll come out to things that I do, because I do a lot of shit in the street. So That's I don't know what song, but
I mean, it all just reminds me of, like we were previously discussing, like communication and conversation, right? So of course you get with somebody, you're a big personality, right? And you do a lot of things. Mm-hmm. So a woman that is with you, either short term or long term, has to understand that. But that's also asking for a certain level of maturity,
trust,
and trust. And a lot of people have trust issues.
Rightfully so.
A lot of people have trust issues, right? And some people don't recognize they have trust issues until they're in certain situations. And that could be when you take them out to a bar and everybody knows your name.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Right? And they're finding it hard to find their footing next to you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I think when I want someone and I go to like their space, I just be quiet. I'm like, all right, I know I'm with her and I'm just going to quietly be in this space. That's just how I move all the time. I just want to absorb the room because I know you're going to see me because I'm unavoidable, unfortunately. And so let me just not make you even more whatever you might be if I go in super hard. In some rooms you have to, but like I think I have a very patient aura. So like, okay, I don't know, this is my first time here. Maybe I might come back a second time. And after you come back, consistency always wins, I think, regardless of what you're doing and who you're doing it with. You know what I'm saying? The way you can more you be consistent with the good, the bad, and the ugly, the better the results are. And also never be afraid to start over. Some people are just afraid to do something out of they get in their condition, their routine, but routines will kill you.
Yeah.
And routine will kill you. If the routine doesn't have a ability to grow with the time you got, because shit, time is running out. Time is short, baby.
It is, but some people don't realize that, right? And it's very, very comforting for them to stay in that same place.
Mm-hmm. Stay in the hell you know, because you know the street signs.
Yeah.
Stay in the hell you know, because you know the motherfucking street signs. See, I don't know if I stole that one or made up myself. Some shit I'd be making up, then other thing I'd be stealing. No, I'm not getting this. You get no credit. All mine.
Cite your sources.
I should, but I don't. Some of the good ones I do. What are your trade-offs in a relationship? I don't even know what that means. What are your trade-offs?
What do you mean?
One person I know, like she was like, it's certain things she don't want to do if I have a man. Like I should be taking out the trash. Or like I know some people, I know relationships where like they don't like doing laundry. Like the woman don't. So the man will. You know, he don't want to, but like he understands that it's not her thing. I will do that. And you know, for her, like she had a problem cooking, but she hate dishes. So I'm like,
yeah,
okay, fair enough. I can deal with that. Like for me, I don't have much of an issue doing anything that keeps the peace. You know, that's not an activity I'm not willing to not do. It's like a lot of women don't have proper pussy management, PPM. You know, like back in the day, I remember my aunties, my mama all had a man that they could do something. Somebody gonna come shovel his front. Somebody's good for moving. Somebody's good for, I need to ride to the store.
Well, she was strategic.
Yeah.
She was strategic.
Right. Everybody wasn't getting it, but she knew how to properly maintain these relationships for her benefit. Sometimes she did, sometimes she didn't. But I'm like, why am I helping these independent minded women moving their furniture? Well, y'all ain't got no men that want to fuck y'all. They come up, move this shit.
Maybe they don't want pussy to be payment. So they didn't ask them to come help them move.
You don't have to always pay for it, but at least get some shit moved. Why am I here? I ain't fucking none of y'all.
Is that what you want, though? You want that type of transactional relationship with all of them?
Hey, what was the question?
Do you want that type of transactional relationship with all of them?
You just got to have friends for things.
I agree.
You usually have some friends in your life that, wow, I don't even know y'all. I'm here because my friend asked me to help him. And I'm saying, I'm huffing and puffing. I'm trying to figure out how to get this motherfucking TV screen in this motherfucking bedroom or whatever the fuck he was carrying. Y'all ain't got no man for this. So what are you doing? You got kids, so you clearly you're doing something. Okay. But ain't nobody here helping move this fucking furniture?
No. They are on bad terms.
You got bad PPM. Fuck, you ain't got a work husband that's going to help you move some shit?
I think a lot of work relationships don't translate out of the office. So for these 8 hours and these four walls, we're together. Anything outside of that, it's a no-go. That's a no-go.
Work husband shit is funny. I'm sort of happy. Like for me, I think I avoid a lot of common pitfalls or opportunities to make bad decisions because none of my jobs were in places where, like, you meet women that's in positions to make bad decisions. So, like, every place I worked always had adults that wasn't playing my little goofy ass and they live in other parts of town. Like, all my jobs, luckily, I never had a work situation because I was either the youngest person in this division because of my size and maybe my maturity to where everybody I'm around, either it's ain't no women here or the ones you want or grandmamas, like real grandmamas, not these young grandmamas, but the real, you are a grandmother for a while. Okay. I know distinctly you are an auntie. You look like an aunt. Like, you know, these mamas and new mamas, you don't know who their sisters are fucking. What are y'all? Why are y'all wearing the same outfit? I miss when people look like their aunties. I was like, man, why are you dressing your son like he your baby, like he your man? Do they make kid clothes? Cause shit, I can't tell. I said, yeah, why do they look like the same outfit? Like that shit throws me off. I'm like, where are the kids in kid clothes pictures? All the kids I see, these kids in grown people clothes. Sorry,
I can't tell people how to dress their children.
I can either. I ain't got none. I just wonder if they still make kid clothes like we used to see kid clothes.
Yeah. Okay. But it's a different time. So I mean, when we decide to have kids, if we get to that place, we can put them in the hard bottom shoes.
Right, the kids even wear hard bottoms anymore. I didn't learn to walk.
They're figuring it out. They're figuring it out.
Damn. The mama and the son in hard bottoms. They both babies. No daddy be around. No daddy be
horrible. Firm. That's horrible.
And don't get me wrong, I love me a good single mother. You know,
struggle with single dads.
Yeah, I don't even know. That's just baffling. That's single daddy stuff. Yeah, that's crazy. How does that work? It doesn't.
Oh my gosh. I'm trying to decide. I don't want to answer this.
Like, was he a single dad? Like, had a kid full time? Or like, single dad? I see him on Fridays and Saturdays.
I've had both. Yeah, I've had both, and it can be bothersome and a deterrent. Because I can't. Who am I to be like, oh my gosh, you have a kid? And people make their own life decisions. You were a whole person before I met you, so you might have kids. But then that's my decision to be like, how much am I willing to take? And what I've learned from dealing with single fathers, or you know, them sharing custody, is like, oh, you actually do want a lot of time. Like, quality time is your thing. That's your love language. Mm-hmm. And so, and I would never want him to be a deadbeat dad, or that man to be a deadbeat dad. So I'm going to suck it up, and, you know, either I'm going to be like, okay, well, I'll see you when I can see you, or I'm just not going to ever see you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's the truth. Oh, shit. That's the truth and shame of the devil. I agree with that. Yeah, I try to be very compassionate, understanding to, you know, because we're the more of the exception than the rule. Like, there's few of us and a bunch of them. Don't get me wrong. I tried to throw it away a couple times before I knew better. My guy thought better of it and said, nah, not this one, young man. You got some shit to do. Because there wouldn't have been no podcast if I'd have had babies when I was trying to have babies.
I have never thought that I wanted to have babies. I mean, I would, let me say, I at this point in my life, if I got pregnant, I would figure it out, mm-hmm. right? But it's never been like this. Nagging, like I need to have children.
Yeah.
Because for me, that doesn't define my femininity.
Right.
And I love being a community auntie. Like, mm-hmm. I love celebrating mm-hmm. your children. Right. I love being able to, like,
all know, right, podcast.
See?
Exactly. It's like, I love being able to come to the track meets or to the games or to donate mm-hmm. to school things. You know, I'll buy the popcorn.
But no one in.
Oh, that wasn't it. My bad. That's it.
Podcast Poppy.
Oh, that's, yep. Yeah.
Right, I'll buy the popcorn and all of this.
I'll buy the TJ's pizza that's overpriced. Why is shit so expensive? And the cookie goddamn. Dough and oh, God.
The best chocolate bars in the world.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Girl Scout cookies.
I'll buy it. That's cool. Yep. Like, I love seeing my friends, in the family way and pregnant and having the time to crochet them a blanket, right? Mm-hmm. I enjoy that part.
A baby shower. I don't get no baby shower. I don't get no invitation to shit.
Oh, I went to a really fun baby shower in I think that was last fall. It was so fun.
Damn.
Good games, good food, good people. But she's a good woman.
Yeah.
Right? So.
Damn, man. My friends ain't doing none of that shit. I don't see none of the people I hang out with. Yeah, I don't see no one doing that no time soon. I don't see no weddings coming. I don't see no baby showers.
I feel like life surprised you because we can't see it don't mean it's not something true. working.
You make a plan, and God makes a better one. You laugh, yes, your plan. I laugh at you.
Evil genius.
I laugh at your making plans, El Negro. What do you think this is? My sister got two kids. I'm down two. I ain't gonna catch up. And so, this one girl had like four kids. I was like, it's not gonna work. Like, ain't no way you have time for four kids and me.
I think some people.
You want a fifth?
I think some people have really good organization skills and they know how to balance their time. Others of us cannot. Either we don't or we refuse to.
My balancing time is including in what I do. So this is my schedule this week. Where do you want to meet me at? Because we haven't got to a point where we can change this. Because I'm not only going to be here. So if you want to meet me here, I will be here doing this. Then I might come through here. My phone. If I don't reply back, probably because I don't want to. But I'm usually have my phone somewhere within reach. So what are we gonna do? That's just how I move. Like this is what I'm doing these days. Because all my days is always booked on doing something. If it ain't throwing darts, I'm probably having a podcast. And that's just where my life is at right now. I do venture out. I venture out within those things, you know. But I do feel like I missed out on the work. I don't like I missed out, but I'm glad I missed the work stuff. I hear somebody like, you hooked up with blah, blah, blah from work. I said, why would you? That's not going to work out. That's not a good idea.
Maybe because I'm a serial worker. Like, I was at the library for a very long time, like nearly a decade. Like, I just, none of that was beneficial for me.
Yeah.
Like, now, I will be honest and say some of those patrons got knocked down.
Yeah.
Some of your uncles and brothers and cousins. I will be honest about that. It wasn't like a slew of them, but you know. What's happening, DJ? Feel the band
know what we best. Get a little bro, them a job. Hey, hey, hey. You gon' eat or you gon' stop. Bow, 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 bow.
Sorry. I don't know what that song is. I'm old.
I know, girl.
I'm old. But yeah,
that was Lil Baby.
There was never a coworker that was like, oh man, I gotta hop down. That just was not the case for me.
Jay-Z.
I didn't even want them to call me. What you doing, girl, with all that? What you doing with all that ass? Let me touch it. Let me feel it. She say it's mine, so I smack it when I fuck it. Freaking the... That sounds exactly like some of the male patrons who would come to the library. Like a lot of y'all people are reckless.
Oh my God, that was fun.
They're reckless. I will say that was the first time I met an older man who was like, he would literally house you. Like he had a dope huge house, and he was stable. He was stable, and like you didn't have to worry about. You just showed up.
You want this guap? Make the pussy pop. Hey, hey! No, don't stop. It went for all 55. I wouldn't know that song.
They play a lot of interesting
music. They play some music. Here's another one. We talked about this one. Which one?
Is this Fruity? Big booty, big shoulder pink, shoulder pink, yeah, stand up anything, like on Frank Lucas. Hey, hey, hey. Big booty, big shoulder pink, shoulder pink, yeah, stand up anything. That just lets me know I'm getting older.
She said, I'm a dog. I'm a dog on these bitches. I said, whoa, wow. Sir. Damn.
That's a lot.
God, I'd be like, I'd be clutching my pearls, man.
And I can't say not to say it. I can't say that. It's that. That's another, you have that free will.
It has its place.
Make your song. Make your song. And I will be like, oh, this is a little too much for me. And I'm going to just move on. I'm not going to tell the people not to listen to it. Be like, that's just not for me.
You totally right. God damn, but that motherfucker do hit, don't it?
That bass, it is nice.
Oh, damn. There we go. Like on Frank Lucas. She said, I'm a dog. Bitch, I'm barking on me, peachy. Bitch, say, I'm a dog. I think for me, my environment saved me from a lot of decisions.
Totally.
Because I know this, I've seen plenty of women that I would be in trouble with if the environment was different. So I think my God has protected me from my own lack of good, strong free will. Because I'd throw it all away right now. She'll
even
know.
Let me tell you
it.
Something. Being a fat girl in the 90s, early 2000s, really protected me. Like, like, really held me down. Right, so I know the girls are wearing their culottes and their skorts now. Baby, imagine it's 97, and that's your only option is a skort, honey, from the woman's section. Ain't nobody checking for you. At least not for me, because I didn't know that I was cute until I was like 18 or 19. So, despite, you know, I was this, the way that I'm shaped has been the way that I've been shaped since I was like 12. It did not register to me. It didn't register to the boys around me. It registered to their uncles and such. But I was so oblivious and so in my child world that I didn't want anything to do with that. But yeah, but being a young fatty, a young chub master in the 90s and the early 2000s, please, best.
Why your face so ugly? That's rough.
That sounds violent, doesn't it?
That song is...
Could you imagine being at the club in 2005 and it came on?
Somebody getting pregnant after this shit. I don't even know what to do. I don't know. What do you do? What do you do?
It's threatening. You have to shake your ass. Apparently.
Wow.
But yeah, I mean, I feel like you said... Environment saved you. Environment saved me. I feel like being, you know, I'll stand on it. And I know fat experiences are all different. And I'm not saying it's been great, but I honestly wouldn't trade anything for it, because I've seen some people, and I'm like, well, maybe if there was 30 more pounds over there, it wouldn't have been the same result. I don't know. But you can't catch me in a skirt today. Not in this millennium.
No. Hey, here he is. You're always on my mind. Sexy motherfucker. Chris Brown come back in my fucking sexy motherfucker.
Sexy motherfucker, you the baddest one.
Brown is rough.
Damn, Chris Breezy.
That's rough.
God, that's a record right there.
That's rough.
Yeah, he's just Chris Brown, Chris Breezy.
I hope he gets the help he needs.
Yeah, he just keep getting got. The guy keeps getting him. What are we gonna do? This is a great song too. Another one of the songs I found. With DJ Luke Nasty. Hold on. Play me some Macafucka too.
What? Is that the next part of this?
Yeah, all right. Go ahead, let the beat bit. We'll let that walk over there. Well, thank y'all for listening and watching Cognac Corner.
Play me some Macafucka too.
Hey, DJ. DJ. DJ.
Play me something
nice. That's a lot. But that also lets me know I'm in a different place in life, because there was a moment in time when I was in these nightclubs and meeting all kinds of people. And some of the men, that was their life. And they would play that kind of music, and I'd be like, I gotta get out of here. Like, this is real cute for the moment, but don't get caught up.
Hey, throw it back. Hey. Hey, a good throw it backer is a game changer. Because every woman is not necessarily the best rider. So everybody needs ain't the same. Neither is their balance. Man, it's a lot of things that you should know what to look for to know if she really feels the way you think she feels about you.
I feel that a lot of truths are exposed when you engage in that type of intimate mm-hmm. interaction. A lot of truths are exposed. And some people will work on skills and some people will not. Some people will allow it and some people won't, because I'm a one and done. There's been one man that I've been like, okay, we can try this again. But if I did not enjoy the experience, be well, beloved, but lose my number.
I undersell and overdeliver. Like, this is going to be trash. You sure you want to do this?
Oh, I feel like the best course of action is to not say anything.
I don't.
Just don't say anything. And that, because that's the tell. I feel like we've heard that over and over again. If somebody brags too much about anything,
yeah,
they are going to fall short.
Yeah, but she... You need a project, bitch. Hey. Rap, bitch. One don't give a fuck and says she took that dick. You need a project, bitch. Rap, bitch.
Daddy, come back. I got your man. Don't
impense. Hop that pussy for me, do a handstand.
Please stop telling our ages, because I heard two different songs. I'm like, she's gonna take the whole refrain.
Wait a goddamn minute.
Like, is this big pun?
Say it is a big pun. Mm-hmm. 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 That's what he did to him. Thank you, Fresh Montana and Doja Cat. Man, we are old, fam.
I would not have guessed that's who that was. But that's not saying much, because I can't generally recognize French Montana's voice unless I know that's his song.
Yeah. Damn, French Montana. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, he got the secret to success.
That's another song from All 55.
Is it?
Yeah, I think so. I might be lying.
I really enjoy myself every time I go there.
I do too. Even like that's my job. They're gonna overserve you. You see a lot of beautiful women that you can't have, but they make you feel like you want to do better.
You know, I'll be honest. I have not seen too many men in there that I'm like, I'm finna shoot the J.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a...
But I always have a good time.
True.
I feel like the men that come in there, I mean, they are partnered. They are settled down in life. I don't see too many, like... I don't want no young gunner. I don't want the people to think that. But a single option, a viable option, you know, I don't see many of those in there.
Yeah, I think it's the 30 and older bar and it's new. And like, I see a lot of men, like, cause hey, those, like, that's for me, in my opinion, is I love it. That's you bring your side chick spot, cause they ain't gonna be about to get there. And you dip off into the back patio. Hey, come say, and okay. It's always open. It's low key and it's off the cut. You know what I'm saying? Who's going down there? If you down there, you there on purpose.
That's very true.
You ain't like you just, oh, I ended up in suit load and a bunch of boys. Nah, this is here. That's like, there.
That part of the South Side is very much, you have to know it's there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you get me with some darts every time. You give me a dartboard.
Excuse me, Shunny. Do you know where I can find some booty?
Why your face so
That's where I'm at.
And I was not expecting that to be the next one.
Hey.
Pop that pussy like a clip.
Whoa.
She in school, but she stripped.
Woo.
Like hands, but she
hit the dick. Ooh, I'm trying to hit a whole click. Down ass up when she...
Pop it. Pop it. Pop it.
That's interesting.
I can't even watch twerk videos. I'm like, oh, shit. Whoa, wait a minute. I'll be.
You realize how conservative you are the older you get.
Yep, I've been reading that in books.
How conservative and traditional we actually are.
I've always been like, I miss the outside, but like, a lot of stuff, like, wait a minute. Are you sure? I fuck up the moment with questions. I'm like, wait. Is this for me? You telling me I make. You know what? Never mind. Like, it's over. Now I'm not trying to clean it up. Shut. What do you say? Put your top lip
on your bottom lip.
And just hit,
Send the fuck up.
God damn, young man.
Take that with you.
But I just want to put it on for my city.
Keep popping your shit, nigga.
You could play it.
I'm trying to put it on for my city, baby. We got one. We got one, baby. Whoa. Let's hit it one more time. Bow, bow. Hey. I got to show you this video when it's over. You gonna, I'm going to put it on the big screen, too. You go on the big screen and what you see this shit in its fucking entirety.
You know, and I can't be mad because I feel like my driving motto in life is that I want people to be their most authentic selves. Mm-hmm. If you can't be that around anyone else, if we come in contact and we're in community, I want you to be comfortable and be your most authentic self. So when the people make these type of songs, they're like, well, girl, they're being authentic. Or at least we hope they are. At least we hope so. So, I mean, you tuck your mother's demeanor in and you go on about your business. Go listen to Anita Baker and soothe yourself.
I wish I could see all the kids that moms were like at the Freaknicks on the Luke videos.
You see them all the time.
All the girls going wild tapes.
You see them all the time.
They wear name tags?
No, they are living their lives, man.
They a daughter and they sharing the clothes, huh? That's them.
No, nah, not if they was at Freaknik. They are probably grandmas.
They absolutely are grandmothers. If
they was in their stride in 94, 95.
If I could find you on a Luke tape.
I know this is your podcast, but I'm gonna mention a different podcast.
Please go ahead.
It's they did the history of Freaknik. Please listen to it. And I'm a research type of gal. So I was so glad that they were able to merge research and hip hop in this mecca. It was wonderful. Please listen to it. Yeah.
Oh, damn. All right. I got something to look into because we got some shit to find out. That sounds good. What's the name of the podcast?
It's Freaknik. There's like a colon, but it put in.
Oh, so the title is the subject Freaknik as well.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. How many episodes is it?
I feel like a strong 10, I think.
Oh, wow. How long was the episodes?
Like an hour.
Oh, that's some content.
You good?
Yeah.
Like, because he's doing interviews with people. He finding people who used to work for the city government.
Oh.
Yeah. That man did his thing.
Round of applause. I gotta reach out and see if I can do something. I gotta do something with this platform. We need that conversation. Man, that shit sounds good. Freaknik. I remember VHS's. And when porn was like you had to work hard to get you a porn. Yes. You had to really do some shit.
Focused. You had to have a plan.
Yeah, man. You had to find a magazine. You had to get the VHS, crack the doors. You wanna see what you're watching, then you fast forward and shit, you trying to see it. Oh, it was a lot of work.
I feel like Cinemax was a godsend.
Yeah, Cinemax. I think my shit was HBO,
and then HBO for a moment in time there was giving you what you needed.
Yeah,
as a youth, like you could figure some things out.
Yeah, I was watching it. I was giving myself blue balls. Then you know I was watching it, but I didn't know what the next step was. And it took me
I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, I was like, all right, I don't know what the move is, but I'm a proud person where I need you to give me like you say, instruction. So I do A, then I get to B, C, D. Cool. Then let me absorb this, make sense of it. And I was like, oh, why I'm a ball. I don't understand why my balls hurt so much. What is this going on? This is painful. All right, HBO Max, I'm a 10. The channel rips. You go back and forth. And go last. You hear Sam? What was you watching? Shit, SportsCenter?
Nickelodeon.
Right back to my place.
Nickelodeon, Roundhouse. Are You Afraid of the Dark?
Rugrats, that kind of shit. Fuck them with HBO. Don't let like we get like it's like some free shit. Like we had Playboy for like free for like 6 months. I was like, y'all don't even know we got this show.
It was a wild time.
It was a wild time. I had a friend that his daddy was like the porn king on the block. So like,
really?
Whenever he get a chance to slide his dad room, be like a closet and another closet, and he like hand them out. We got to get them back to him. Like, this shit is crazy. I still to this day have a the big CD cases. And like before I officially left and went digital, I still have old porn DVDs in there when I used to go to the flea market on the Rock Road before they tore it down.
Dedicated. bad.
Only because my friends was going. So I got to go to the flea market. I'm going to go. I was like, oh, let me get that one, that one, that one. I get 5 of 20. Let me get that one, that one, that one. Oh, that looked good, dude. Let me see.
That's really good. That's dedication.
But then when the iPhone came out, I mean, it doesn't make any sense. You know, only thing that changed in my life was that I did cross over the paywall during the pandemic. I didn't have no like COVID babies, but I did start paying for Pornhub Premium and Xvideos Red.
I never will give them money.
Yeah, you shouldn't. You shouldn't. You're in a place where you don't have to do such things. And for me, I just like, well, let me do my stupid pandemic purchase. And I was like, well, never going back to that shit because this shit is great over here. So I got a whole playlist and shit. I'd be like on Netflix and I'm like, what's on new today? Oh, okay. She got a new one out. Okay. I don't know what's your production studio. Okay. I like that. I condom sex on porns. Offensive. I'm not here to see safe sex. If I ain't having safe sex in my life, why the fuck I want to watch safe sex on the screen?
Well,
I'd be like, I understand you. They have respect. They want, it's how they choose.
I don't have a problem with that because
I do. I'm offended. That's like seeing you. That's like seeing Marvel movies. Like Iron Man being reasonable, not blowing up a building. No, I'm here to see action. I want my. I know
you're
this
still
is
getting the action.
Nah, that condom's in the way. I want to see the heads explode when somebody dies.
That's a hard stance.
I just I can't watch this. I'm offended.
I mean, they could do like an action figure where they rip it off when it gets to that point.
Why is it there?
Because they want to be safe. Like they do.
I respect their decision. I'm just not going to support it.
Man, you gotta watch a different video, man. I like that being safe.
I like it. I like it to be how I'm living.
But I reckless.
Bang bang. Where are my gunshots? You hit it. You did that. Let me get my gunshots. Where are my gunshots? Where are my goddamn gunshots? Where is the violence? Well, hey guys, I've been telling you this for 4 years. I'm gonna get better at this. I have not.
I think.
Here we go. Gunshots. All right, we got the gunshots. But yeah, I get offended, and I've got to the point where like I'm into production, so like porn is like, you know, the world. Like the white people got the nice, they always have like nice big homes and storylines and like random in the kitchen. Like, it's a beautiful home. Y'all getting this nasty shit on. That's the reason I be going to these nice houses. Like, oh, this is a nice house. But they do some nasty shit in here. Mm-mm. All my references are all bad. This is a beautiful home. Y'all can shoot a porn in here if you wanted to.
You know, that is one way to think about it.
I just like production in my porn. That's all. I don't like it. Just hit it and they just already, oh, how you already in the, I mean, how y'all get here? I need a story. Just talking fast forward, I was like, oh, this is the number. Oh, stepson and okay. Like, no, this the neighbor.
I don't want to be in it for more than 5 minutes, honestly.
Yeah.
I don't want to watch it for more than 5 minutes.
Well, I was gonna add a section to this show that's at an hour and some change. It was called, I was gonna call it If I Had a Girlfriend. Just so I would get in the habit of like putting it out into the world. I feel I should be somebody's boyfriend for the sake of our growth as individuals and as a together. So example would be like, you know, when I'm at darts at league and, you know, I have a good round and I'm taking, you know, a series off. I would like to go, you know, FaceTime my girlfriend and tell her how well I did. I'm probably drinking and I'm probably gonna talk some shit because I know when I get home, either to hers or mine, preferably hers, that I'm gonna hit another bullseye. And that's why I really find valuable having that's why I feel it's so valuable to have, you know, the availability of a FaceTime. Because I remember I met this one girl and she was like trying to FaceTime like while driving and shit. Like, are you crazy? And I was like, I do it all the time. I was like, she's ahead of her time. I'm bad. Like, I am bad. Like, I do more shit while I'm driving than shit. I'd be like, all right, I'm just driving. Boy, you can put that goddamn phone down and you enjoy 21 Savage going down the motherfucking highway. I'm like, get it together, young man. Another thing is I would do like my best days, my brightest days are days when I do something podcast related. So it's like a new maybe bridge I built with somebody else. Like, those are my better days. I'm like, oh, had a great day. Who can I call to celebrate with? Damn. Mm-hmm. No one cares with me. And the best part of fucking was pillow talking. This is what I used to say. I say a lot of things that bite me in the ass. This is one of those things I used to say that I don't say no more. I said, I used to fuck just so I had pillow talk. Then it took me serious, so I had to stop saying this shit. I'm like, no, I still want to be fuckable, but I really just want to get to the pillow talk. That's my favorite part. I kept saying it too often as I was getting, then here we are. But the point is, I like to celebrate my wins and my losses if I had a girlfriend, but I don't. So I have to work on it.
I think you can make a known to the universe if that's what you want, right? Mm-hmm. So I also had to get into that space like we talked about earlier. Like when you change your standards, you have to realize that it's going to be quiet on your end for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Because I am definitely a believer in having a roster. Let me look in the camera. I want the people to know.
Oh, shit. Let me give you a camera. Oh, here you go. Bop. You got it.
I want the people to know it is okay to have a roster as a woman or femme-presenting person.
Candy, I had a shot. Candy, you almost caught the pistol.
Femme-presenting person, it is definitely okay to have a roster, but also know your limitations. If that's not you, sis, don't be out there in the streets because you'll get run over, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, but I still believe in that, but I'm also at a point where I need my roster to look different and offer different things. Mm-hmm. And my goal is now to have a star player. I want somebody, you know, I want to give you the glittering gold J around your neck.
You trying to give him a Rockefeller chain?
I want to give him a, you know, Rockefeller suit, white Nike. You know what I'm saying?
Well, it sounds like you're talking about proper pussy management. And you got to have proper pussy management even to maintain a roster. Because everybody ain't going to get it, but everyone needs to believe they will. Nothing sells better than hope.
And honesty.
They both kids with H.
Yeah.
Also does the word hoe. But that's hope that the honesty don't lead you to being a hoe.
Or if you want it to lead to you Triple being H. a hoe, that's fine too.
And it's okay. Hey. Every hoe, the best housewives are hoes.
And I believe it for whatever gender you subscribe.
Yeah, there's nothing distinctive about that. You know, the best husbands I know was hoes.
Look, I got a big booty bitch from the south side. She a freak, but a knock a bitch out.
Hey.
Paid a foursome with her click. It was hogging.
That's a dirty ass. So my main it bitch of knock a bitch is out, sir.
It's filthy.
We have Candy in the building. What's going on with your dirty ass?
You asked. There you go.
Candy was one of my best friends. You know why me and Candy so close? Cause she got a blue box. So I like to FaceTime, and she picks up sometimes. More times than not. I am really anti. If you have a green box, and if you don't know what a green box is, well, it says a lot. That's a requirement. Like, I'll just add you to my plan. Like, I'm at the point where if I meet a girl that has a green box and we getting like serious, or it don't have to be serious. I might just get a line just as this is an extra line. So, okay, we're talking. This is our phone, like a bat phone. So you keep this on you.
That's
for me
because
I'm paying for it. And I want to FaceTime when I want to FaceTime.
But you know, you can send a link to everybody now.
So what I was saying was, so this phone, you can add other phone numbers to this phone while we working this out, but it doesn't work out. I'm going to need it back. Mm-hmm. And I'm delete all the other shit out this phone.
That's an investment. I'm not willing to do that.
Yeah, no. I mean, I haven't done it.
I want you to pay your own phone bill and have your own phone.
What I think, if we start off with, like, I really like when I be out on these fucking dating sites.
I hate the
data. Oh, it's trash. I don't do well on them. Not like I used to. It used to be keyboard gangster where I would be, my best shit came off.
I figured out that I have low patience. And I've also figured out that a lot of men do not have as strong of personalities as they think they do. And communication skills.
Oh, yeah. My shit great. If my shit's bad, because I don't get fucked that much. But, damn, I mean, how to make that about me. Go ahead. So, bad meme with bad.
No, you were saying you were a keyboard gangster.
Yeah, like that's really where I scored first before I got able to win outside. You know, I was a MySpace, AOL Messenger party line nigga back in the day, and I was on the webs early. So you know, that's why I text with very good synthesis unless I'm wasted. Right. And you know, I can do a good back and forth, but like I just don't be like I just like the actual like just not motivated enough right now.
I think I have the motivation, but I also realize the times in which we're living. Like, I was not early on the internet dating stuff. Once I realized that I was, you know, attractive and all of that, I was like, my personality is better experienced in person.
Yeah.
Because you're gonna think that I'm mean and that I don't have a sense of humor. You're not going to get my sarcasm. Mm. You're not going to understand the tone via text a lot of times.
Yeah.
Until we build up that rapport.
Yeah.
So I need to meet you out in real life.
Yeah.
For you to understand that. Oh, no, I'm actually very kind.
My spot. My
jokes land, I promise.
My meet and greet spot, we used to be Big Daddy's and Sulu. Meet and greet was my shit. I was like, hey, y'all going to see me here all week with different people. Don't act like I've been here all week, okay? Just play the tab. We keep moving. Because ain't nobody remember how to get back to this motherfucker's place anyway. They'd be like, bit as in the land. I'm like, nigga, you old I am. How I look be on the fucking landing? No, the grown one in the Sioux Lord. How I look like the landing? I'm offended. Is the landing still open? I hope it ain't. That shit should be closed down.
They're renovating.
I need some goddamn juice.
They're renovating that
some
area.
Motherfucking juice. Motherfucking juice.
What's your next question?
All right, Jizz. We can wrap this motherfucker up, actually, because I'm ready to get my.
Did you go back to your first section?
Oh, the first section was the week that was. What was the good and bad of your week?
You know, for real, like, honestly, I feel like I've really been doing this emotional work. Mm-hmm. emotional and mental health work. So I can never say that I've had a bad week. I'm probably the best that I've been emotionally in the past 3 years.
Round of applause. I ain't put no juice in that motherfucker. It's just liquor, nickel. That's good. The emotional work. I think I read a book. I got a book that's called Emotional Intelligence. Mm-hmm. And I took, you know, read it and I took the little test and I realized, like, emotionally, I am solid, but almost to a fault to where I'm not emotional enough. So I'm not very impulsive. Mm-hmm. You know, I sort of go through the whole process of possible consequences when sometimes the moment requires you to make a decision in that moment. And I have a habit of missing moments because I want to make sure this makes sense. And sometimes life is to be lived. The human life is built to make mistakes, and people are more than prepared to forgive you for it. But if you don't make the mistake, it's really hard to connect with people because they've made mistakes.
You have to be willing to take a chance on yourself. Mm-hmm. What I've learned living this adult life is that vulnerability is not a weakness. Mm-hmm. It is a strength.
Mm-hmm.
When you understand it. And there's nothing wrong with feeling your emotions and letting your emotions be as big and broad as they might be, but giving yourself an actual opportunity to feel every one of them and recognize what needs to change, right?
Mm. Everything you said has made me feel like a place I'm giving you right now. Ooh, are you on your way? Are you coming soon to me?
Sometimes I feel
party
like,
in South LA.
Sometimes I feel like Giveon is very. I liken him to those light skinned Canadian artists because they'll say a lot of things in a sing song manner.
Keep going.
They'll say those things in a sing song manner, but it's really some fuck shit.
Mm-hmm.
But it just. It's very melodic because I just really started listening to The Weeknd because I'm like, that nigga's gonna roofie you. He's gonna roofie you.
Party Next Door he had a couple songs. I was like, this is a horrible song.
It's horrible, but he's that phrasing and that sorry, get it out of my face. Please go home. One of us needs to leave, preferably you, because I'm having the time of my life.
Ooh, y'all don't know how many times I've driven home and listened to Adelvion and just it's almost like the way I used to drink and drive.
Mm-mm. You ready to sit in those feelings? you are prepared to sit squarely in that hurt.
Now you're ready to drown in that water.
I'm not going to do that. I'm going to put on some shorty swing my way. And speed home. I'm gonna think of myself as a fly girl in the 90s with a finger wave.
My ass, I heard this. This is how we get home. Play the goddamn song, bastard. Woohoo. Yeah, I mean, just smoke my little smoke down the road. Wishing I had somewhere to go.
You got some place to go. Yeah,
home. I wish I hit up you up. Wait, I mean, see you up. Text will come through. You up always. Hey, always. You don't.
You don't want them no more.
Shit, I ain't getting enough of them when I was getting them. I'd be already sleep with my eye mask on. Half mask has ruined my life. What you get? What you say? She was here when she said that. God damn it. She was here when they said that about me, my sleeping mask. And I don't appreciate their accuracy. That's true. Especially a new Adele album. There's certain songs I shouldn't feel so attached to. Honest, as a man, I haven't listened to don't that. Do it. I listen enough of both of us. I love all the wrong songs. All right. Let's see. Let's get the fuck up out of here. So you got any closing thoughts, young lady? Where they can find you, where you going, you know.
I mean, you can find me on the internet. Sometimes I post things. You can find me at MZ_Jenkins on all the places that you probably stalk your exes.
Damn. You know, I ain't never had somebody like got from my out of some like DMs. I ain't never had them like, oh, I met him in the DMs. Mm. I'm not a DMer. Like, I don't know, man. I just feel like, I don't know. I guess I'm old and hang with young niggas too much. I'm like, I'm not in a DM. I get offended when I meet a girl. She's like, what's your Instagram? Bitch, what's your number? I say, you know what? You right. You too. Clearly, I should be talking to you. Where's your auntie? Or your mother?
No, I appreciate a good phone number exchange, but I am not going to lie that I have shot my J in a DM and have landed the shot. I'm very much a proponent of a woman shooting their shot. If you know, if that's your thing, please do it. And if it ain't, I feel like you need to adapt it.
Okay, so what do you say? What is the verbiage?
Oh, honey, I start simple. Hello, I compliment them because unfortunately, men are not used to receiving compliments.
Fuck no, say, is this for me? I'm. Well, that's a good song. Too.
Stuck you compliment on you. Them. You take a quick look at their page. Let them know that you're paying attention. And be like, hey, I like that place that you went to. What would you recommend I get there?
My dumb empathy. Oh, this is where you go. Yeah, it's pretty good.
They're people, so you have regular conversations. And then you let your intentions know. I'm trying to be down. I'm trying to hop down on you. And you see if they with it. And if they're not, then okay. No harm, no foul. Yeah. But I feel like just be straightforward. Yeah.
We had a discussion about you and you saying it's friend shit, okay? See, this is why that's why Scorpios will always be who they are, because they don't want to do nothing that's for anybody else besides their damn selves, okay? Scorpios are the kind of individuals that they're great to be around and have as friends, but they gonna keep you sharp. They gonna keep you on your toes, dirty bastards.
Oh no, we appreciate that.
You're not Scorpio, are you?
I am not.
I'm about to say, but no way.
Some people that I care for are.
Me too. I collected a lot of Scorpios last year. Way more than I planned on it. Give you a guy, I be feeling some type of way. I ain't got nobody to call when I feel type of way. All my hoes is in better situations with husbands and families. I said, God damn it, I should have left more hooks than bitches. What?
I mean, I feel like that's the perfect segue. That circled the conversation right back to where it started.
All right, y'all. So, any closing thoughts from this show?
Man,
give my audience the connoisseurs a closing thought, please. I'm gonna fight Candy.
Please be your most authentic self, and people will accept it. I promise. Once you're comfortable with yourself, everything will align for you.
Cut the audience off. That's a very good message, and I thank you for sharing that message with us. So this is closing your tab. She closed her tab.
I will close mine. I want to thank all the connoisseurs for entertaining this foolishness for another episode. I'm going to try to get better and do better, but thank you for sticking with me, all nine of y'all that download the episode when it comes out. I see y'all. I want to let you know I care about y'all. I'm going to do better. The 100th episode will be coming up very soon. I'm thinking I'm going to do something, we'll be in March, probably around mid-April. 100th episode. I'm thinking I have a location in Sulu that I want to confirm before I say it, but I think we're going to have something good coming up in April for Cognac Corner. We do have a Rare Air Art Show, which is the 26th of this month as a Saturday. AFM is doing a live show. That means that's going to be me, Mark, and maybe RJ. If he's there. RJ Dirty Ass. Let me tell you something about RJ from Black of All Trades, who's on the FFAFM network. He's a great human being, but he can't leave them white girls alone. He just can't leave them alone. And I know it's hard. I'm a 15-year veteran. No one did more dope than I did, you know? And I managed to make a decision to move towards home. Now, don't get me wrong, it's been a struggle. It's been sometimes I wanted to give up and quit. Sometimes I didn't know it would be this hard, but it just comes to a point where you just have to stick with it. And eventually you receive a level of peace you never thought you could receive. But for those that can't leave it alone, I understand. But you, at some point, you're going to have to make a decision. And I hope you make a decision before the decision makes you. And that necessarily wasn't all about RJ, but, you know, this is a PSA for those that ain't quite made it home.
Hit dogs will holler.
Am I the dog?
No. I mean, we can also let your listening public know that I am single and ready to mingle.
She's outside and available. You can find her. Her DMs are always open.
You know, slide in the DM, see if we can transfer like quick that. Trip. See if we can transfer the DM into a telephone number exchange. I like to go out on dates. Take me to the arcade.
Arcade. I said, I'll be taking motherfuckers right to the dartboard. And we're going to get something to eat. And we gonna order some drinks. I'm gonna beat your ass in these darts. And
I feel like the best first dates are movement activity first dates.
Yeah,
they're the best ones.
Yeah, for sure. I agree. Yeah, I don't know. I get so I'm so Sular. It's fucking ridiculous. All right, I am. Wait, that's not it.
All right, podcast Zaddy. But no one and nothing is necessarily perfect. Come on.
Neither is the show.
The podcast Zaddy.
Podcast Poppy.
And we are.
You're done.
And I'm closing my tab. Love can be the road to happiness, but most times happiness leads you right to the doorstep of love because only happy people can be in love. One more time for those in the back. Love can be the road to happiness, but most times, God damn it, happiness leads you right to the doorstep of love because only happy people can be in love. And as a bonus, trust is lost in buckets but gained in drops. Uh-oh. One more time. Trust is lost in buckets but gained in drops. And extra is an extra bonus. Growth scares people that don't want to change, okay? So once again, for those in the back, growth scares people that don't want to change. So love yourself, love each other, and love is all we got. Show it to me, goddamn.